Welcome student to our chemistry lab. So I welcome all of you to our chemistry lab students. Hope all of you are fine. So today I have come up with a demonstration, and today I am going to show you how acid and base can be identified with the help of indicators. Now for that I require the indicators: litmus paper, red litmus paper, blue litmus paper. I have taken acid. This is hydrochloric acid. I have prepared the solution of hydrochloric acid. This is sulfuric acid. I prepared the solution of sulfuric acid. This is calcium hydroxide, and this is the solution of calcium hydroxide. This is sodium hydroxide, and this is a solution of sodium hydroxide. And another indicator I have taken, that is phenolphthalein. Here I have also taken distilled water. This is normal distilled water. I have taken a dropper, a glass stirrer, a test tube holder, and okay, so let's start the demonstration for today. Okay student, often we have problem to identify that how we will understand which is acid and which is base in the lab, right? Because they almost look like similar. So externally, by looking at, you will not be able to understand that which is acid and which is base. For example, if you see, this is hydrochloric acid and this is sulfuric acid. Can you distinguish them like that? No, it is not possible. See, this is calcium hydroxide and this is acid. Okay? So can you distinguish like that? No, it is not possible. Okay. So what we do, we take the help of these indicators. Okay? So normally in the lab we use various types of indicators. The very common indicator is litmus paper and phenolphthalein, right? Phenolphthalein is an acidic indicator, and we also use methyl orange, okay, universal indicator, pH paper, those also we use. But today for this demonstration I have used only litmus paper as indicator and phenolphthalein as indicator. Okay, so let us first see what happens or what is the effect of this litmus paper when I put inside the acid and base. Okay, so first let's see what happens. So I am taking a red litmus paper, student. So here I have taken a red litmus paper. This is a red litmus paper. I am taking a solution of concentrated hydrochloric acid. This is the acid I have diluted. Okay, so let's see what happens. See, I am dipping this paper inside. There is no color change. So red litmus paper is showing no color change with the acid, right? Now I will take another litmus paper. This is blue litmus paper, right? Now blue litmus paper, let's see what happens or how it changes. Does it shows any changes with the acid? So the same acid I have taken. Now I am dipping it inside. Just observe it. See, dear students, the color is changing, isn't it? See, as I dip it inside, the color is changing. You see? Okay. Look at the change in the color. So blue litmus paper changes to red. Now this is how we identify that whether the solution is acid or not. Okay, so whether the solution is acid or not. So in order to show one more, see, I am taking another acid. Here I have kept sulfuric acid, so I am also taking the sulfuric acid solution. See, I am putting the red blue litmus paper again. See student, see, turn to red. Okay, so here also we see that the blue litmus paper turns to red when we use acid. Okay. Now let us come to this. Here I have used, dear student, calcium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide solution. Let's find the effect. What effect they have on the litmus paper? First, I will take the blue litmus paper and let's find the effect. See, dear student, this is calcium hydroxide solution. Calcium hydroxide solution is a base, so I am dipping it inside. Is there any change in the color, student? Did you see any color change? No, there is no change in the color. So I am keeping it here again. Okay, so there is no change in the blue litmus paper when I dipped it inside the base. Okay, so let me take another blue litmus paper and dip it inside sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, so here we have sodium hydroxide solution. I am dipping it. Is there any color change, students? No, there is no possible, or there is no color change we have observed. Okay, now let us try with the red litmus paper and see what is the effect on this calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is a base. Now I am putting the red litmus solution. You see, students, you see calcium hydroxide solution, there is a change in the color. Students, see, gradually the color is changing. See, the color changed to blue, right? The color changed to blue. So which means if it is a base, then the color will change to red litmus paper will turn to blue. Now let's see what happens when I put this red litmus paper into sodium hydroxide. This is a sodium hydroxide solution, student. So this is a red litmus paper. So please note it, what is happening. Just see. See, again the color is changing. Did you notice, student? See, the color changes. A blue litmus, red litmus paper turns to blue. Red litmus paper turns to blue. So one thing we learned today, that if it is an acid, then red litmus paper will not show any color change. But if it is a base, then blue litmus paper will turn to red. On the other hand, if it is a base, then blue litmus paper will not show any color change. But if it is a base, if we put a red litmus paper, immediately it will turn to blue in color. Now, let us take and see what happens with the phenolphthalein. Now, phenolphthalein, student, is another indicator. Phenolphthalein does not show any color change with the acid, right? Now, I am taking, okay, so now I am taking hydrochloric acid. See, I am taking hydrochloric acid in this. I am adding few drops of phenolphthalein. Let's see what happens. There is no probable color changes. Okay, so we did not see any probable color changes over here. Okay, now if I add the same phenolphthalein solution, if I add, this is acid, in acid I have added phenolphthalein solution, students. Okay, so now I will add, just a minute, I'll keep it here for a few minutes. Okay, now I will add this same phenolphthalein solution here, students, with the sodium hydroxide. See, this is sodium hydroxide I have taken. Now I'm adding this phenolphthalein solution to sodium hydroxide and let's see what happens. Just see, look at the change. Can you see? It is changing to purple color. Okay. So this happens when phenolphthalein is added to base. So whenever we add phenolphthalein to base, if it is a base, then the color will change to purple or pink in color. Okay, so students, today we have learned that with the help of indicator we can understand which is acid and which is base, right? Now one more thing before I end for today's demonstration, I'd like to show that what will happen if I add the same this phenolphthalein added NaOH. Okay, you can see the color is still purple. Okay, let me add a few drop of it. One more drop I am adding to make it prominent. Yes, now what will happen if I add this base to acid? Let's see what happen. Okay, just notice student, the color is getting vanished. Yes, I am adding this phenolphthalein, you can see the color is getting vanished. Magic, right? Actually it is not a magic, it's a chemistry. See, the color is getting vanished. You know what is happening actually? Yes, see, the color is getting vanished. This is happening because I have taken acid and on the other hand I have taken base, right? So when acid and base, when this is a base student, sodium hydroxide is a strong base and HCl is a strong acid. So when adding this acid and base together, then they are neutralizing each other. And because they are neutralizing each other, so you can see what is happening. See, now I have added more amount of base. Now on the same time, if I add more amount of acid, see, you can see again it is getting neutralized. See how it is getting neutralized. So as it gets neutralized, the color will gradually fade off. Okay, you can see as it gets neutralizes, the color will gradually see. Can you see students? See. So this is neutralization. So with the help of indicators, we can understand which is acid, which is base. These are the simple indicators we have used, student, to make you understand how to identify an acid and a base in the lab easily with the help of these type of indicators. These type of indicators are available in every chemistry lab. So whenever you visit to the chemistry lab, you can easily identify by using this type of indicator, litmus paper, phenolphthalein. Okay, you can easily identify which is acid and which is base. Just remember one mantra: alkali lal ke kare kali. Mean sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, the bases which are soluble in water, they are known as alkali. Okay, they will always do red litmus to blue. Lal ke kare kali. Okay. So here we have seen that this alkali, the sodium hydroxide, how it has changed red litmus to blue. Okay, hope this video was, or demonstration was, helpful to you. Thank you for watching the video.